6.1, we're starting factoring, and 6.1 is the basis for our other sections. So this is greatest common factor, and then factor by grouping. The way you'll know you're factoring by grouping is that there will be four terms. Greatest common factor has always got to be your first step, no matter what the problem looks like, no matter how many terms. And this is going to be an easy piece to forget. So what I suggest is when you get to test time, write the word GCF in every box so that you make sure you don't forget. Maybe minimum, write it on the bottom of the page to double check, because if it says factor completely, you have to do that. So if GCF is pulling the largest term out that goes into all of the terms, it's basically, again, backwards distribution. So on this first example, I can pull out an 8y cubed. I look at the coefficient, 16 and 8. The biggest number that divides into both is 8. And the biggest exponent that's in common will always essentially be the smaller exponent. So now you got to be careful what's left. 8 times 2 gives me the 16, and I have a single y left. And this is where you got to be careful. There's nothing left, but you have to put a placeholder because you have to be able to distribute and get the answer back. I mentioned last week that you needed to be careful on the test. When do I factor and when do I multiply out? These will say factor completely. Chapter 5 will say simplify. So make sure you differentiate. Going to number 2, we look at the coefficients, and a 5 goes into all pieces. The smallest exponent that would be in common of all of them would be m to the 4th, and looking across, x squared. Again, we're asking either two ways to look at it, what's left over, or what do I multiply by to get that? You can look at it as a division, or you can look at it as multiplication. So I've pulled out the 5 for the first one, and I've pulled out the m's. I have a single x left, because that would give me the x cubed. 5 times 3 gives me 15. I pulled out 4 m's, so there's 1 m left, and I pulled out 2 x's, so there are 4 left, because when we divide, we subtract the exponent. The last term here, 5 goes into 20, 4 times. All of the m's came out, and all of the x's came out. That's my answer. Super easy to check by just, again, not necessarily even do it on your paper, just visually check by using the arrows to see if you distribute it correctly. Now, if you have a choice, I know this says to factor either a negative or a positive out, but this is the preferred form. Both will be accepted on the test and in my math lab, but when you get into the next chapter, chapter 7, they will expect you to pull the negative out. So if the first term is negative, please make sure you pull the negative out. And there is an error on your paper. This original piece should have been a negative a cubed to match what we have below. So please add that. The second part for 6.1, which you will use again in 6.4, but how do I know when it's mixed together? Factor by grouping is done if you have 4 terms. Still needs to be GCF overall first, always. So we look across example 3, there is no GCF out of all 4 terms. So since there are 4 terms, we are going to look at them as pairs. So I'm going to underline them. And I'm going to separately say what's the GCF of the pairs. So out of the first pair, I can pull out a 5x squared. That leaves me with 3x minus 2. You will always bring the sign down, and out of the second pair, I can pull out a 2, and it leaves me with 3x minus 2. In order to keep going, these always have to match, because we're basically backwards foiling in this case. We're figuring out what to get for our two binomials. If they match, that comes down, and what is left over goes into the other parentheses. That is my answer. I do not write the 3x minus 2 twice because I'm pulling that out. I'm factoring that out, and what is left over goes into the other parentheses. Looking at number 4, key on this one is there is actually a GCF across the board. So you've got to pull that out first, which is a 2. I am going to circle it because I'm going to ignore it once I pull it out, but it is super important as it's part of my answer. So you may even want to draw a line and put it at the bottom so that you know you're keeping it. You don't have to worry about it in the in-between steps. So now I'm going to look at the pairs. Out of the first pair, I can pull out an x, leaves me with 3x plus 4y. The sign always comes down, whatever the sign is in the middle. Out of the second pair, I can't pull anything out. So this tends to throw a lot of people off. I'm going to always put 1 there as a placeholder. Now, some of you may think that that 3x minus 4y is left, but notice that they don't match. You will catch your mistake there. I actually pulled out a negative 1, so that should flip both of my signs, because let's check. That gives me negative 3x and a negative 4y. So if you pull a negative out, it should flip both signs. But you will catch it because the parentheses will not match. They have to match to go further. So 3x plus 4y is what matches. It comes out. What's left over goes into the other parentheses, the x minus 1. Don't forget the 2, which was my GCF, because if I leave that off, I will not get what I started off with. Going to number 5, scan it, there's no GCF, but should always be your first step. So now I'm going to look at the pairs. Out of the first pair, I can pull out a 5 and an x, and that leaves me with a y minus 3. The middle sign always comes down. Out of the second pair, the 6 comes out. It has to be the biggest piece. And remember, you pulled out a negative 6. So it flips your sign. If you forgot that, they won't match. It will catch your mistake. So the y minus 3 matches. What's left over comes down to the other parentheses. And all of these you can check by foiling out. That's my answer. So looking at my last one, there is no GCF across all 4 terms. So we're going to look at pairs. Out of the first one, I can pull out an M. Out of the second one, remember we always bring our sign down. And again, in this case, there is nothing in common. Get in the habit of putting the minus 1 as a placeholder because it helps with the following step. These match. 6M minus 5N comes down. Left over, m plus 1. I can verify all of these that are in my boxes as my answer by going back to what we did in chapter 5 and simplifying by multiplying out. If it says factor completely, the GCF has to be pulled out and it needs to be written in parentheses form, which in this case, when you're doing factor by grouping, it should end up being 2 binomials. Okay. So they have to match in the in-between step.